angels and demons. It's not a fantasy movie, but it does have a little bit of a setup that involves some amount of science. I got kind of interested in it because the science that comes at the very beginning talks about the Large Hadron Collider, which is a new particle accelerator in Europe, and that was very prominent at the very beginning of the movie. It's a bad guy movie, so most of the movie is not about physics, which is why people like to go see it. So I don't know a whole lot about Dan Brown or all the books that he's written, but usually they involve the Vatican, and usually there's some bad guys in the Vatican, and that's the basic premise of all Dan Brown books. What I thought I'd do is first set us up with a little bit about what the movie's about, and then we can sort of parse out a little bit about the physics that's going on. It was kind of amazing, the timing of this movie, and maybe it was deliberate, but some of you might know the Large Hadron Collider, this accelerator that's featured in the movie, actually turns on this year. So this is kind of a big moment within the physics community. A lot of us are very excited about this new instrument. Some dub it as the largest scientific instrument ever built. And so it's kind of a big moment for us, and imagine a lot of physicists and everybody getting all excited about a new instrument, but this is that far away. So let me start by setting up what the movie is. Okay. So I'm going to show the trailer for the movie, and then we can talk a little bit after that.
Selected. We are under attack from an old enemy.
Find Professor London.
He exposed one of the greatest cover-ups in human history.
Da Vinci.
But what terrifying discovery would make the Vatican turn to him?
That's Illuminati.
The Illuminati were a secret society dedicated to scientific truth. The Catholic Church ordered a brutal massacre to silence them forever. They've come for their revenge. There's a hidden trail through Rome itself. I need access to the Vatican archives.
Access to the archives is only by written decree by the Holy Father.
Fellas, you called me. This is the first sign.
What sort of sign?
Earth. Air, fire, water, and the fifth sign.
May God forgive you for what you've done.
Father of God has issues. They won't be with what we've done. They'll be with what we're about to do.
Our church is at war.
Hey! This is the first marker. The path is alive. You're talking about the moment of creation.
Open the doors and tell the world the truth.
It has to be here! This is it. This is the truth.
Angels and demons.
The story starts with CERN, and CERN CERN is is an international laboratory. It's just outside of Geneva, Switzerland, and it's a host to several particle accelerators. It's a rather old laboratory now. It looks really glamorous in the movie. There are lots of fancy-looking buildings, and any of you who have ever seen a physics department, those of you who are not physics majors, not too many glamorous buildings around here. Those of you who are physics majors are keep wondering, where are the buildings that don't involve cinder block walls? That's the one I want to be in. The real CERN laboratory has somewhat more modest accommodations. It's a beautiful place, though. You're out just outside the mountains, and if you're looking up from that picture, you would see the mountains straddling Switzerland and France. So in that sense, it's very nice to be there, much nicer than the particle accelerator I work at outside Chicago, where you see the plains of the Midwest. But not particularly a top secret laboratory by any stretch. CERN was started in 1954, and it was an idea that had been kicked around for several years by several very prominent European scientists. Some of you might know the name Niels Bohr. He was one. Others include Pierre Auger, who amongst us physicists is a very prominent name. But the final proposal that got developed and then sent on to UNESCO, for some of you who know what UNESCO is, was done by Louis de Broglie, another Nobel Prize winning physicist. And the idea at the time was to find some avenues to develop international collaboration amongst the nations of Europe, which literally 8 years before had been blowing the crap out of each other. So this was a pretty revolutionary thing to have done. And again, the goal here was to try to heal the wounds of World War II. So it was very much from the beginning set up as an avenue for international collaboration. So that's a really remarkable thing. We don't even have that in the US. When there's a major new project going announced but from the federal government, instantly you see states shooting at each other. Not quite literally, but you know, there's competition to get the new projects, and we don't even have always the same level of collaboration within the 50 United States as is present within the nations of Europe. So it's a remarkable enterprise. Today it has grown from 12 member states which organize and operate the laboratory to 20 what are called member states that operate the laboratory and sit on the council that governs CERN. And there are about 9,000 scientists that are routinely use CERN from around the world. That's a big number. There are even 1,000 of them from the United States that want to go over and be participants in the projects of the Large Hadron Collider. So it's a big fraction of the community I work in and others here in the department work in that are going to do their science overseas at this new facility. In the movie, you see toward the beginning, the secret scientists doing their secret kind of work, and one of the more realistic depictions of the movie is they show the control room where they're going to dial up the antimatter, and that's actually not a bad depiction of what real life looks like. They have these fancy looking computer monitors and nice iridescent blue there, and they have all the scientists in their lab coats, and that's not really realistic. I don't know too many of us that wear lab coats anymore. But the right-hand picture over here is the actual control room for the Large Hadron Collider in Geneva. So it's not so different. There are three very large pods there where a number of or teams of people are sitting around a bunch of computer monitors, and each computer monitor is accessing or monitoring some key part of the accelerator, be it the cryogenics or the magnets or instrumentation to find where the beam is. Everyone's got their little piece. This kind of looks like a control room in Johnson Space Center or something like that. So that's a very realistic part of the movie. And these people are all sitting there as chaos around the control room when things were really starting up, also kind of like in the movie. One thing that's actually quite false in the movie is, in the left-hand picture here, right outside those windows were the experiments that were going on in the Large Hadron Collider. So particle collisions were happening right there, and you could watch them, you know, looking through the window. You would never see that at CERN because the actual accelerator is located some 300 feet below ground where it's safe. So all accelerators are generally located well away from where people are because there are particles colliding, which means there's ionizing radiation flying all over the place, and you don't want to be near that. So the actual control room is actually a couple of miles from any access point of the CERN accelerator, and you aren't anywhere near it. You're accessing everything. All the information is coming through electronics, up cables, up through mine shafts, and out to the control room. In fact, you don't even have to be there a couple of miles from the accelerator. There's another control room.